Looks like JPEG got hacked. Read-only reentrancy? Why doesn't anyone follow chain security recommendations? 2 hours later, Alchemix got hit by the same attack. Turns out it wasn't JPEG that got hacked, but Curve itself, and its pools are being drained at an alarming rate. Curve deletes the tweet. They clarify that a few of their stable pools have been hacked. Other pools are safe though. Hours later, their own Curve ETH pool gets hacked. Curve was the sixth largest DeFi protocol with over $3 billion in total value locked. While most protocols are coded using Solidity, Curve chose a different path, using the Viper programming language. But as we later discovered, smart contracts compiled with these versions of Viper contained a critical bug. It was unintentionally fixed in a subsequent release, but the details remained largely unnoticed until now. Curve had been using vulnerable code for years, and we only found out when hackers used this to drain a total of $61 million. Luckily, Lido dodged a bullet. Their staked ETH pool, developed using an older version before the patch, was thankfully not vulnerable. With $400 million, a hack of this pool could have wreaked havoc on the staked ETH peg, potentially destabilizing other protocols. Nonetheless, this put Curve in a difficult position. Out of an abundance of caution, people rushed to withdraw their liquidity positions and Curve lost half of their TVL. Meanwhile, the Curve token was down bad. So bad, the founder of Curve was close to getting liquidated. This could have triggered a cascading effect, further crashing the price and leaving lending protocols with bad debt. Let's look at how Curve saved itself from a total meltdown, as well as an explanation of how the hack worked. But first, let's go back to the beginning. 11 days before the hack, this wallet was funded with 0.1 ETH from Tornado Cash. Later, it deployed this contract and called the start function. But the transaction failed. A mempool bot front ran it and sniped $11 million. 1 week after his failure, the original attacker sent a message to Curve. "Sorry, I made a mistake. My transaction failed, but if it was successful, I will return it." Given the simplistic nature of the hack, I think it's entirely possible this was a genuine white hat attacker, or he messed up the hack and is now claiming innocence. The good news is that bots are usually ethical when it comes to returning stolen funds. In the aftermath of the hack, JPEG contacted this bot asking to discuss a white hat bounty. After no response, they reached out again with an email address. He replied, "The JPEG team issued this formal statement. Legal action will not be taken against you. We view this occurrence as a white hat rescue, and as a result, you will be rewarded with 10% of the rescued funds. Depositors will be made whole, and this 10% comes from the DAO itself." He agreed and returned 90% of the money. In the meantime, a white hat group was looking into the chaos. Remember back when Curve announced all other pools were safe? Well, Chainlight quickly realized the CRV ETH pool was also vulnerable. But minutes before they could hack it themselves, they were beaten by an exploiter who drained most of it. We'll come back to him later. So he had stolen most of the pool, but not all. Chainlight tried to recover the remaining funds, but a researcher made a huge mistake. Due to a mix-up, the transaction was sent through the normal mempool instead of flashbots. As a result, someone had front-ran the attack. Moving funds to Cold Wallet for now. Affected protocols can contact via Etherscan chat. Deployer from Curve. One transaction you front ran was a hack of the CRV ETH pool. Can refund? Yes. Please send me a way to contact via Etherscan chat. An hour later, he returned all the funds to Curve and also returned the funds from another pool he front ran. After that, Curve contacted the CRV exploiter. You know, the original hacker who beat Chainlight. Where should we talk? No response. The next day, Alchemix exploiter sent DeFi666 a message. Anyways, who is this user? After the Alchemix pool got hacked, the swap ratio was imbalanced, so the price of AL ETH dropped to only $4. Immediately, he started buying AL ETH at this incredibly cheap price. In total, he bought 1250 AL ETH for only 4 ETH. Alchemix is designed where each AL ETH represents 1 ETH in value. As others realized this huge arbitrage opportunity, AL ETH quickly repegged. So through this single trade, DeFi666 turned thousands into millions. But it's worth noting that this profit came at the expense of liquidity providers affected by the hack, making this morally gray.
"I made a mistake when protecting user assets, so you get a windfall. I think we should give money back, don't we?"
Curve sent the CRV and Alchemix exploiters this message. "We as a group are offering a 10% bounty, which are yours to keep if you return the remaining 90%. The Alchemix exploiter sent back 1 ETH and responded,
"Please confirm this is your address on Twitter. Make sure we won't make mistake.
Please return funds to the Alchemix multisig instead." The hacker started returning around half of the funds.
I saw some ridiculous views, so I want to clarify that I'm refunding you not because you can find me. It's because I don't want to ruin your project. Maybe it's a lot of money for a lot of people, but not for me. I'm smarter than all of you.
He returned some more ETH.
It was a white hat operation from the very beginning. I was on vacation when I saw the JPEG exploit and I found a place to open my laptop to see what was going on. It really confused me, but I didn't have time to figure everything out, so I write a code and test all ETH pools. I knew many others are doing the same thing. I'm not sure if they will refund, so I need to beat them. I received your bounty message, but I think 20% is a reasonable reward. We can discuss about it. For DeFi 666, I saw your operations on chain. You're really a ridiculous asshole.
Herb asked for his telegram and he confirmed the first and last characters. 4 hours later, he returned the rest of the money and didn't even keep a bounty.
History is written by the victors. I make huge mistake, so you are smarter than me. Great job.
So far, Curve recovered 70% of the funds affected by the hack. It wasn't one single attacker, but a collection of multiple groups rushing to hack or salvage the vulnerable assets. Luckily, all of the major players were ethical hackers who decided to return the funds. Except one, the CRV exploiter. You are the last exploiter to not have returned any funds. The deadline is approaching. Consider your actions and what they will lead to. The deadline has passed. We now extend the bounty to the public and offer a reward of $1.8 million to the person who is able to identify the exploiter. If you choose to return the funds in full, we will not pursue this further. In the meantime, another subplot was unfolding. With 800 million tokens allocated to him, the founder of Curve was worth upwards of $5 billion. But of course, there isn't enough liquidity to sell all of it, and dumping your own token looks pretty bad. At the end of 2020, Curve proposed to add CRV as collateral on Aave, and this was actually Aave's very first governance proposal to pass. Gradually, Michael used his CRV as collateral to take out loans. This allowed him to access funds without exerting downward pressure on the price. However, this wouldn't go without consequence. 1 year later, the highly profitable trader Aave Eisenberg tried to do something funny. See, if the price drops too low, Michael would be liquidated and his Curve would be sold, pushing the price lower. Fresh off recent success, Aave tried to hunt this liquidation by borrowing 88 million tokens and selling them. The next day, Aave taunted users on Twitter. However, Michael coincidentally published the highly anticipated white paper for a new product they were going to launch, which sent the price skyrocketing. 1.5 hours later, Aave's short started to get liquidated. Aave lost millions, and this was a huge victory for Curve, but the damage was done. There were real questions about continuing to have CRV listed on Aave. The chaos caused Aave to accrue $1.6 million in bad debt, because the price moved up so much that Aave's collateral wasn't enough to cover the short. The CRV market was frozen, but soon reopened with a slightly nerfed liquidation threshold. Michael diversified and continued expanding his lending position across other platforms. His collateral accounted for almost 50% of the CRV circulating supply. Aave tried to freeze the market again, but the vote failed. And here we are now. Curve was just hacked and Michael has a massive borrow position, except this time it's worse. Since the on-chain liquidity got hacked, there was even less to backstop a large liquidation. This could have been catastrophic for not only Curve, but also the lending protocol supporting his loans. Michael scrambled to increase his health factor, but it wasn't enough. He decided to sell a lot of tokens over the counter. These users purchased his CRV at a discount, but had an agreement to not sell within 6 months. Still, these tokens would eventually make their way into circulation, diluting the stake of current holders. Anyway, how did Curve, one of the most trusted DeFi protocols, get hacked? Well, the good news is that it wasn't really Curve's fault, but a bug in Viper. Smart contracts are generally written in Solidity, but a more uncommon language is Viper. The goal of Viper is to make things more secure and easier to audit. One of these features is a built-in reentrancy guard. It works perfectly fine, except in these three versions. In the subsequent version, there was an innocent-looking bug fix that in retrospect should have set off alarm bells. Think of storage slots as a stack of boxes. The bug caused these boxes to be misallocated. Instead of each lock having a consistent designated box, it was sometimes placed in different boxes for different functions. This inconsistency meant that while one function might recognize it as locked, another might see it as open. The hack started by calling remove liquidity. Upon receiving the ETH, it bypassed the reentrancy guard to call add liquidity. This add executed before the remove could be completed, so it did calculations before LP tokens were burned, resulting in a higher calculated output amount. Anyone who provided liquidity into these pools was left empty-handed. In the end, most of the losses were refunded, but Curve still took a big hit from this attack. It just goes to show how even the most trusted protocols, with even the best audits, can fail. Thanks for watching.